Hi everyone, I'm in a new province and I just finished up a league with mono red impact tremors. It was super fun to spew goblin tokens onto the board and attack all the time. You can kill your opponent by pinging them with impact tremors in whatever match you want by clicking on the timestamp in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching and enjoy the league. All right, here we go. Won the die roll for match one. Fast gobos are fast. Double goblin war strike. We're gonna make a lot of goblins, so goblin war strike's not actually that bad. It kind of sucks that we don't have any one drops, but I do think I'm gonna keep this here. I don't have them yet, but I will. If the next time I play a lotus petal deck, I absolutely will. You gave me the ticks for it, Ben. Gotta get them. Oh yeah, absolutely. Sneep. So we're gonna lead on Great Furnace because we have the opportunity to. Our opponent will maybe think we're on Boros Monarch. It looks like our opponent's on Boros Monarch. I was hoping it would force them to take their time, or inspire them to take their time, that is. So we'll play out Instigator here and pass the turn. So we're going to be on the Warstrike plan pretty quick, especially where our opponent has Thraben Inspector down. And we might even want to... That's only player. Okay, that's interesting. Tilt coming shortly. Yeah. Possibly Pauper Playable. Already good. Okay, so yeah, Goblin Instigator. Not attacking into it with their Thraben Inspectors. Just to have more copies of Mountain in the deck. So I'm going to cycle a Forgotten Cave first because we're probably just going to Krenko's Command here. There's Impact Tremors. Alright, slam an Impact Tremors past the turn. Yeah, Thraben Inspector blocks our entire deck. we got an Impact Tremors down, though, and we're going to start commanding Krenko and hopefully drawing some Hordling Outbursts, Smog War Marshals. That was a good draw there. Yeah, so Goblin Warstrike. I mean, they have Prismatic Strands and things like that, but I'm not super worried about it. Glinthawk is an absolute house against us. Ooh, is this like Core Skyfisher? Yikes. Okay, just Prophetic Prism. Not a big deal. Opponent, playing birds, drawing cards, etc. Then 11 mana 2/2s with flying. Ben, why do we gotta keep meeting up like this? Okay, there's Goblin Slayer. That's pretty good. So I'm gonna play a land. And we'll Goblin Slayer, and then I'm going to Krenko's Command. Yes, we are playing two Sparksmith's main deck. So we're going to always yield to this. Moto just having a little fit there. Oh, actually, wow. I didn't notice the... I didn't notice that 11-card or 13-card sideboard. Jeez. I'm really glad you said something, though. All right, so our opponent is going to get to trade with a creature here, but that's okay because we already got some damage in off of Impact Tremors. We're okay keeping one of our X1s around. I feel like I might have used this ability wrong, so I'm just going to start over. There we go. So now that'll trade with Glinthawk. We'll get in one damage. Our opponent's at 18. We've got a War Strike. Maybe I should have thrown a War Strike at them before I went to combat there, but we'll find out. I feel like these are for later. Journey, gonna get our Sledder. Not technically, it was kind of a one for one. Krenko's Command made two tokens, and we get some damage off Impact Tremors. Our opponent loots. I feel like we can have so many more goblins though. 11 plus two Sylvok Lifestaff, that makes 13. Like just barely 13. All right, four cards in our opponent's hand. They do have access to red mana. Another Impact Tremors. Okay, well, let's draw some of our token production, please. I probably should have Warstruck last turn. I think I do agree with that, because these could have equaled 5 each, 10, which would put our opponent at 8. And casting them now is a lot less risky than casting them later. Come on, Mog War Marshal. Anything. Any creature that creates tokens. Dragon Fodder. All right, so let's Dragon Fodder. That's going to deal 4 damage, put our opponent down to 14. And I don't know if we want to War Strike. We might want to wait one more turn on War Strike. I don't think our opponent has access to, like, dealing 8 here does what? Puts them to 6, which makes Hordling Outburst lethal. Or Mogwar Marshal lethal. Whereas if we wait until next turn, yeah, actually, I'm kind of okay with that. Because they might start drawing into burn spells or stuff like that. I don't know. I don't know if I want to War Strike until next turn. I'm going to use one War Strike. Yeah, I think one is correct. Because we could draw a Token Producer. Here comes a removal spell. Sure. So it's going to deal 3. Yeah, so I'm going to hold on to it. We might find a Token Producer next turn, and that would be wicked. Yep. And they have their main deck Electricaries, so... going to be Thraven Inspector, unless they did find a land. They might just want to play, pick up Ancient Den, Radiant Fountain. Fair enough. Opponent access to 2 red mana, 4 cards in hand. Yeah, not bad Lightning Bolt value. We are at 19 and we have 2 Impact Tremors on board. Like, I feel like we're not in terrible shape. There's Bushwhacker. So we'll kick a Bushwhacker. Get some Impact Tremors triggers. Are we just going to take it here? So 2 are going to get in. 4. War Strike. Combat. So we're going to put our opponent to 3. That's a ton of lethal creatures next turn. They are going to get to eat a token with Core Skyfisher, but I think it's just worth the damage. All right. We've got a lot of win cards here, gang. Like a ton of them. Opponent finds red mana. Yeah, Prismatic Strands is definitely trouble. But, ooh, opponent getting frisky with the Skyfisher at 3. Probably just have another Thraven Inspector or something. Whoa. Strands? Sure. Okay. Well, I'm glad to have seen it there. So, I don't know if I want to run out Instigator here. I kind of want to force him to flashback Prismatic Strands next turn. I guess there's no reason to attack with these. Yeah, I'm going to hold on to Instigator because it'll force them to Prismatic Strands next turn. I don't think they'll have any discard. Strands is pretty good there, though. All right, see what this is. Palace Sentinels, okay. Well, that would have been a reason to run out Prismatic Strands, or run out Instigator. The life gain off these fountains is going to be relevant. So if they attack here, now they're going to have to tap Sentinels to prevent themselves from dying. So we're going to get to become the Monarch, which is going to be sweet. I don't think that was a very good attack. Because they can't have 2 removal spells for both of our tokens here. So either they die or we get the Monarch. And I don't think a Howling Mine is very good news for them. So let's run out Instigator, threaten lethal so that they have to tap this for Prismatic Strands. Oh no, never mind. Because they can prevent all the goblin damage with Prismatic Strands. True. I think they would still just eat a goblin. Yep, stack the stuff, get the tokens. Right. So yeah, so we won't get to get the Monarch, which kind of sucks. And our opponent's got some blockers, but we got a fairly wide board. So I think I am going to play out Foundry Street Denizen so that they have to commit a blocker to try to beat us here. Obviously, more Prismatic Strands are just very bad. And Electricery is very bad. But our opponent's at 3. Like, how could they have it all? I don't really know. I don't think that's very relevant. Sure. Ooh, they bolt the Foundry Street Denizen with Prismatic Strands active. But we couldn't have, like, won instant speed or anything. So we would have lost a Goblin Token for no reason. Opponent's gonna loot. 2 mana up. We can force 3 damage next turn with many of our draws. No, I don't think opponent is genuinely bad. In any sense. They have three mana for another strands. I guess any attack here kind of signals that they must be prismatic strandsing. Yeah. Wow, our opponent just keeps finding the prismatic strands. Good for them. Would we... What would make us want to block this Palace Sentinels with everything? Like, we might as well, right? Hold trigger on lethal. What do you mean? Oh, like hold an instigator or something? Yeah, I suppose. I feel like they have another strands. I'm trying to think of whether I want to block here. Yeah, because they could put us to 11. So I actually think I am going to... I like slowing their clock down is fine. And them killing any of our creatures means that they can't leave up mana for prismatic strands, which means we can might be able to get an impact tremors kill next turn. So we get to slow their clock down. Mm-hmm. And we'll see if they've got... I don't think they're going to bolt anything. I think this is just going to die. We're going to lose two goblins. Because we win if they don't prismatic strands. Yeah. So they pretty obviously got strands in hand. But I'm going to make them use it. Mm-hmm. All right. Opponent is on the prismatic strands. Win the game victory. So let's go to combat. We are going to attack. We'll force them to strands. No instant speed. Like, that's kind of unfortunate. Okay, so we won't attack. In that case. And I think I might hold... Why? is this on red? Yeah, I'm just going to pass. I'm going to hold on to Denizen. Because just casting two creatures next turn forces them to flashback prismatic strands. Oh my goodness, they have electricity too? Well, I'm really glad I held if they have electricity. Yeah, what's the jank, Terry? Fill us in. All right, Skyfisher getting back Radiant Fountain. Sure. Opponent back up to 5. And I wonder if they found any more prismatic strands. They can certainly cast this one. And then we will have fought through 2. How many do they have in their library? Yep. Journeys. Oh man, that deck is so sweet. And attacks with Skyfisher. We're pretty close to just being dead here, gang. Opponent leaving up removal magic. And their flashback strands. I don't really know that there was any better way to play here, though. Alright, so we will... Dragon Fodder. They'll flashback strands, most likely. I'm assuming they do. I don't know why they would go to 1. Yeah. The flashback strands, we'll hold on to Founder's True Denizen. I don't know that they would have flashed it back if we would have cast this. But the 2 damage next turn might be relevant. So I'll hold on to it. Pass the turn. Let's see what our opponent's got. 4 cards in hand. 5 mana. Ooh, going up to 7. Making this all the more difficult. And I wonder if they found more prismatic strands. How many could they have main deck? 4, I guess. Got a pretty decent clock here. Oh my goodness, they found another one? No way. What? That's so brutal. They might just have enough lightning bolt damage to kill us here. I feel like they wouldn't, like, they're not going to tap it. Ooh, they are going to tap out of Strands mana. All right, we might have a chance. Only 2 red mana for our opponent. Oh my goodness, Bushwhacker, come on. Come on, Bushwhacker. Bushwhacker, please. Okay, Galvanic Blast us. Oh my god! Oh man, savage. We would have won. We would have won! All right. So the Monarch and several Galvanic Blasts took it from us, but that's okay. So I don't think this is the Blazing Volley matchup. We are definitely the aggressors. So we're gonna bring in Smash the Smithereens. I think we do have to bring in Goblin Caves. I think they are just like genuinely good against all the like trickeries we're about to face. Yeah, I feel like we were like pretty close to winning several times. They had two Prismatic Strands and enough burn spells to end the game. So I think, you know, or should we just bring in Flaring Pain? Bring in Flaring Pain? Yeah, probably. So Flaring Pain will come in and Smash will come in. I think that's what we're looking at. Sorry, this is a 15 card sideboard. I only play decks with way less cards in the sideboard. I don't know if Fire Blast is any riskier. Yeah, Flaring Pain and Smash is what we want. I'm not sure what comes out. It's kind of tough. I think Sparksmith. I think Sparksmith is a little too risky, but I don't know. Maybe it's just too slow, I think. So I'll take out Sparksmith. And Warstrike is like not super great against all the removal, but I think it is a way that we could sneak out the game. An earlier Warstrike probably would have won us the game. Like if we would have, that's probably the only misplay I made, was trying to be greedy with Warstrike. So we'll keep that in mind. Next game, what else can we take out? Like I want to make three more cuts, right? Like Instigator probably actually isn't that great. I guess Foundry Street Denizen isn't great because it's always going to trade with like a Thraven Inspector. So I think I'm going to go down Denizens, noting that I'm taking out creatures for non-creature spells. So actually maybe I take out Fire Blasts. Because the game's... Well, no, these are probably better as the game goes longer. I wouldn't mind getting Sparksmith back in there. You agree about Denizen? Yeah. I think Strike is pretty good. I could cut a Dragon Fodder and get Sparksmith back in. And I wouldn't hate a Goblin Caves, but I think that's too slow. Even this is pretty bad, actually. But I don't really know what I want other than that. So I'm going to do it like this. There's not a very good chance that we will draw Sparksmith, so... 30 seconds! Alright, this looks like it can be fast. It does only have one land, but it has goblins and faster goblins. So we're going to keep. And hopefully we find a land eventually. This deck only runs 17 lands, so you have to be comfortable with keeping one-landers every now and then. So let's hope our opponent doesn't have a Bolt for the Netizen. Thanks for looking out for me, gang. Aw, Thraven Inspector. Foiled again. Alright, so we'll play a Sledder. Pump up Denizen, attack. We're not going to sacrifice Sledder to save Denizen, I don't think. Although, maybe we should. It represents more damage with Bushwhacker. By putting Vampiric right on the Death Spitter. Infinite gain life. Yeah, I think Smash is in. Smash is pretty good. This isn't a very easy decision. I think Goblin Slaughter helps the rest of our deck trade up a little bit better. Or trade off a little bit better. Yeah, I think it just leads to more complicated play patterns. So I'm okay with that there. Oh yeah, you were on the granddaddy of... Oh, not another Inspect, come on! Alright guys, well they might have us here. I guess we run out... I think we're gonna give them one turn. We're gonna try to find a mountain. And if we don't, then we're going to run out Bushwhacker and start attacking into this Inspector. But I feel like they're just going to play a Core Skyfisher here, and things are going to get a bit out of hand. Ooh, they're just going to Bolt it. Okay. Welp. There's Glinthawk. Picks up Inspector. Pretty dead here, guys. God, I can't believe we lost game one. Like, that was savage, huh? Like, so many Prismatic Strands. So many Prismatic Strands and Burn Spells. Our opponent just had it. So we gotta run out of Vanilla Bushwhacker here. That doesn't feel very good. Pass the turn. Hey, what's up, Al? How you doing? Settling in for the evening. Opponent's gonna draw a card. Probably make their land drop. This is not good YouTube value, losing in match one. But we'll just take it. Ooh, we found a land. Okay, that's interesting. So what do we want to do? Probably just make a jillion tokens. Whoa, thank you very much for the bits. Type one, how you doing tonight? How is your gold fishing going? You making some progress on your brew? Gobbies! Here comes opponent, Electricry. Savagery. Electricry, leave up Prismatic Strands. They cast it four times. And it is, like, unusual for them to draw two Prismatic Strands. Like, how many would they have in their main deck? Not many of these run four in their main deck. They probably only had two. It was lucky, okay? They had two Galvanic Blasts, two Prismatic Strands exactly when they needed them. So, variance that. Yeah, we're just going to keep making tokens. And eventually try to Bushwhacker FT-dub. Bushwhacker, Goblin, Warstrike, that whole shenanigans. Yeah, absolutely easiest to drop in the Discord. We just gotta not die to a bunch of attacks and burn damage. That's okay. Read away. Just let the Asmar carry you away. Just whisper it. Guys, this is the Asmar portion of the stream. If everyone in the chat could please just be very copacetic to an Asmar plan, I'd really appreciate that. So let's just all get really comfortable and relaxed together. I'll rub my face. Okay. Opponent played some birds, drew some cards, did the Monarch, and attacks for six. So we're at four. We're within range of two Galvanic Blasts, which means I think we need like Mountain for Warstrike. There's two Warstrikes. I mean, are we just dead next turn? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. So I just don't think we got there because we can only represent what? 1, 2, 3 damage and then 10 them. So we whiffed on lands for just too long. I think land there might have done it because we could have Bushwhackered. They could have blocked. We would have gotten in for 8. And we would have been able to Warstruck for 6. Now, even then, wouldn't have done it. What's up, Shades? Almost got through it without laughing. Was it the face rubbing? I think we're dead, guys. Because they can attack for 8. We have no way to block any of their flyers. And yeah. Missed a land drop one too many times. I think is going to be the story of this one. Just trying to see if I have a way out. This doesn't target creatures. Unfortunately. Let's count all the times that this was worse than Galvanic Blast. But yeah, I think we're dead. So that's it. I guess we'll make him do it. Run out Instigator, pass turn. Ugh. The match one losses. Man, we had him in game one. That's so brutal. Oh, it was so close. It came down to like seconds. Maybe they'll punt. Maybe they won't attack with their Skyfisher. Who knows? But they probably have a non-zero number of burn spells in hand as well. Yep. Opponent knowing full well we're dead. Gonna cantrip a little bit. And maybe let's just Galvanic Blast us twice. Beautiful. Opponent had us dead in multiple ways. Alright, so that's gonna be the Monarch matchup. So we got savagely burned on an opener like this, hoping to draw a second land last time, but we only run 17 lands. So the chance of us drawing lands is like, or the chance of us mulliganing into a land in a six card hand is like lower than 70%. So I think I'm actually, I think you have to keep one landers. Like, I just not, I'm just not, I'm not okay with a coin flip, especially where it's possible, and our opponent's on the mull too. So it's possible for us not to find lands at all. Ooh, Aura Flux, Aether Flux Reservoir got downshifted. I just missed it. What's up, General Canada? How you doing? All right, let's go. Opponent is on turn one, Forest, which is interesting. A number of Sledders on turn one is good. We'll see what our opponent's up to. They're on Ixalan Forest, which could be relevant. They might be a newer Pauper player. Maybe we can sneak one out here. So I'm going to F6. I don't really know anything in green that I have to worry about. Have the matches wrong. And yeah, see what our opponent's got. Oh no, a million BTEs. Okay, guys. Okay. So I think we're just going to commit Impact Tremors here. And we're probably going to let our opponent get in for some amount of damage. If we want, if they want to Alpha Strike, Foundry Shree Denizen backed up by Sledders and tokens and stuff is pretty good. So we found the land, we got the Impact Tremors down. We're gonna give our opponent a turn, and giving Stompy a turn, not always a great idea. They could have like Hunger of the Howl Pack plus, you know, any number of crazy RNGesus is on our side. Yeah, Library of Lang's a pretty cool card. I don't know that we have a good Stompy matchup. The Stompy matchup is kind of contingent on us having or drawing into our interaction, of which we have very little. 7 billion gobos. Hey guys, did you guys notice that this deck only has 13 cards on the sideboard? So I'm almost okay with them wasting their maybe I'm not. I'm almost okay with them wasting their whatchamacallit that way. Because, ooh, my War Marshal. That's a good draw. So I think we're just going to War Marshal here. Especially because we can sack it to Goblin Slayer. We're probably not paying its echo cost next turn. They only have a 2-2 on board. So they're going to take 2 damage. Although I might want to chump with this. So I'm probably just going to attack into Nest Invader with Foundry Shoot Denizen. What's up, Maverick Girl? How you doing? So sad. I think you will play the Orzhov deck. Oh yeah, no. So last night was Orzhov. So you can check out the past streams and check that out. But yeah, Grim Harvest was a blast. Gush, gush, gush. Yeah, the Grim Harvest deck was a lot of fun. All right. Ooh, up late. Gotta get your sleep, Maverick Girl. Now don't make me give you a talking to about sleep and the importance of it. Like I said, I would like to chump BTE with War Marshal, so I might not sack it to like sack 2 tokens to trade with Nest Invader here. What's sleep? Only one of the most important things in the world. But we are kind of even with our opponent here on clock, so I can appreciate that. There's Quirion Ranger. Hey, I sleep moderately. Alright, so our opponent's gonna get in with some stuff. We are going to block here with War Marshal. And block here with a Gobbo token. Planning to or do we just take 4? We're gonna sack War Marshal, we're going to get another token. We can trade with a Nest Invader here. I actually think that's what I want to do. Did I say something racist? Oh, God. Oh, man. Brutal. Yeah, catch up. You got to catch up. Okay, so we are going to not block with that. We are going to use its ability, though. So blocks like that. Opponent will pass priority back. Hopefully I didn't just pass all the way through somehow. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna pump this, sacking this. create a token and trade with Nest Invader. Obrigado. Is that a famous composition that I'm not aware of? Maybe I like that one. All right, so a whole bunch of triggers happen. Man, I've been trying to find ways that I can try to get to sleep earlier too. Ooh, they're gonna hunger here. Okay. That's not great for us. Sure. So our opponent has no cards in hand, but 2 5-5s on the battlefield. We're just gonna chump block our way to victory here, I believe. We're just gonna cast tokens and tremors them out. So we have tons of ways to produce tokens, so I'm just gonna keep doing that. The first match was Boros Monarch, and that first game was just like insanely close. Like, insanely close. I couldn't believe it. Donata. Cool. I am not cultured. But yeah, I think I might pick up some melatonin or something like that, because I've been having trouble sleeping too. Trying to force myself to bed at a reasonable time. You guys should look it up. The consequences of not getting a proper night's sleep are well documented on YouTube. It's dangerous. So our opponent only has one card in hand. I think I'm going to probably chump, or I'm going to let one of these 5/5s through. So we're going to block like this and block like this. And I'm okay with them kicking a vines here. An Alpha Strike isn't going to do it for us, so this is fine. We're going to make enough tokens to block for the rest of the game. Just kind of like leaning their board down is pretty good. Yeah, tell me about it. That was the main purpose I had for losing sleep too, and it's really not worth it. I'm telling you guys. And I'm not using your lack of sleep as a soapbox. I'm really sorry if it seems that way. It's just kind of been my mantra lately. Okay, pretty happy to find a land there. That means we're going to be able to Dragon Fodder, drain our opponent for 2, Goblin Slutter, and we're just going to have enough blockers, I think, to kind of eke this one out. Yeah, Rancor is a big, big trouble. Big trouble in Little China. All right. So Goblin Slutter comes down, and we are pretty close, especially if our opponent does Alpha Strike next turn. Yeah, another land did it. I could use one more land and like basically win next turn. That would be rad. Yeah, no attacks, I don't think. I guess we could reasonably attack with this, but they just block with River Boa, so it doesn't really make any sense to do that. Attacking with everything, how does that feel? Could I just win? No, because I can't attack with 4 creatures. So, if they can't kill us this turn, I'm pretty sure we win. Let's see what our opponent wants to do. Your turn, 1 card in our opponent's hand. And we even have to block the Boa this time because a kicked vines could kill us. So we're going to lose 3 attackers. But I think that means with Dragon Fodder, we can get in with lethal. Let's see what our opponent wants to do. Swing, 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 heart is my... So we are going to play around kicked vines because I don't want to throw this game away for no apparent reason. And I think we'll block like this. Yep, going to regenerate the Boa. They got an angler. Dang it! Oh, what does Fel Spectre do? Thank you. But really, like, thank the All-American Rejects, because they're the true heroes here. I could save this Goblin token. I think I'm going to do that. So, click on this bad boy. Sack this bad boy. I mean, I don't really think it matters. So now we've got 4 attackers, we're going to have 6 creatures on board, we're going to put our opponent to 5. I think we win here. I guess if they have another blocker, that's problematic. Mm-hmm. Oh, they have 2 more blockers. That's very problematic. So they have four blockers now. They can block all of our attackers. Fabulous. But we're not out of it yet. Another land means we can Krenko's command. Get some triggers. So we're going to drain them for four here. And dragon fodder. And if they want to attack at all next turn, I think that means we win. And I think we still just win anyway. Next turn, so... Yup. I think we just pass. Continue playing around. Right, because they have one, two, three, four, and they can even return a forest to untap another blocker. So I think just attacking with four creatures here isn't going to do it. So we're going to pass. I maybe should have swung with this, but a little nervous about them untapping River Boa. Opponent goes to Combat, and we will continue playing around a Kicked Vines, because that's the life that I'm living right now. I don't know. Not sure. Not sure about that. So we'll block like this. Yeah, I think if we can keep him off trample, we might be okay. And when our opponent passes priority back, we will we'll sack some goblins. Alright, so we're gonna pump this guy, sack this guy. Pump this guy, sack this guy. Pump this guy, sack this guy. We're not in great shape. Like, I know it looks kind of okay, but we're not in great shape here. Because our opponent might be able to get a couple more blockers here, making it a lot harder for us to win. So they can still block with four creatures. Oh, they're at three, though. No, they can block with five creatures. Not another Nest Invader, please. Burning Tree, okay. So they have five blockers. Functionally, they have five blockers. And while we can kill a couple of them, we still have to just draw token production. All right, I think Bushwhacker does it. So they can untap one, and they block with one, two, three, four, five creatures on our five creatures, but we can still sack enough to win the game. So we'll cast Bushwhacker with Kicker. Drain them for one. And then swing with the team. That's a game! That makes me want to... Do you guys remember when the Game podcast came out? And it was like Jerry Thompson... okay, now's not the time to wax nostalgic. I gotta win this game. Oh, man. Thank you very much, TMJ. I appreciate that. That's really nice. Thank you. Yeah. You lost? What do you mean you lost? All right. So what are we bringing in? Are we the control deck? Or the 16-land control deck? I don't think so. I don't think we have enough sideboard for that. It's like Goblin Caves, Blazing Volleys, and Sparksmiths. Right? Oh, God. Oh, guys, no, don't. Don't. Do you know how many people you just ruin their night, guys? F. I'm not even going to reiterate that. So that at least the people who can't read are spared. all right, what are we bringing in? What are we bringing in, guys? Are we the control deck? I think Sparksmith is good. Exile target instant or sorcery that targets you. Sacrifice. What? Shell of the Last Kappa? Man, we, yeah, I feel like we've all come together for a particular reason. We've all come from certain places in our lives. The Maverick girl got them all. All right. I can't click on that link for fear of, like, losing frames for some reason. So, what gets worse here? War Strike is probably good. Fire Blast is probably good. Sparksmith is probably... Sparksmith might not be that good. Maybe we just run it back vanilla, like... What do you guys think? I really don't know. I think Sparksmith would be the only thing I consider bringing in. And I don't really know what I would want to cut it for. Whoa, Fluff! Thank you for the host, man. Hope you're having a good night, Fluffy Wolf. Guys. Do you guys have any idea what we should... Like, should we bring in Sparksmith? And what should we take out? Hordling Outburst? Too slow? Denizen? Because it probably won't attack through anything? Yeah, that's the thing, right? I don't know that we can control our life total well enough, but it can get rid of one of their huge things. Life Staff seems solid. Okay. I'm okay bringing in Life Staffs. I'm going to go down one Hordling Outburst and one Dragon Fodder, and we'll do it like that. Okay. Yeah, me neither. But I don't necessarily want to cut him. Red. Mismatched lands. Oh, so Sparksmith is so hard for me. Maybe go with 62. That's it. That's why. Yeah, we have two land in our opener. That's why they had a 13-card sideboard, so I didn't have to agonize over whether I was going to bring in the other Sparksmith or not. They were just like, I've had enough of this. I'm not thinking about this anymore. All right, so we are going to go turn one Foundry's Denizen, and then turn two Mog War Marshal. That too, yeah. I think this hand is pretty good too. Here comes a Pit Skulk. Maybe I should have blocked that. I don't really want to trade this though. Burning Tree? No Burning Tree starts. Opponent. No Burning Tree starts. Stop it. Opponent. Ooh, Sparky Boy. Play land. Do we run this into their, like, they probably have epic confrontations now. I think we do. I think we play Sparksmith. But they probably have epic confrontation. And I'm like, I'm a little worried about epic confrontation. I kind of want to go on the Bushwhacker plan and then eventually do this. But then we're trading creatures, so it won't be as good. Sparky Sparky Boom Gob. You're probably right. This is going to start killing their X2s, but it's not. It's just like, later on, this is going to hurt us so much. Like, this turn's going to matter a lot, guys. So, pressure's on. Hey, thank you very much for the follow, General Canada 99. Welcome. I think we want to start threatening to block some of their 2/2s. I think that's what we want to do. And then they're going to play Elephant Guide or something next turn anyway. So I'm going to run out Mog War Marshal. This is going to let us start blocking some of their 2/2s. We're not going to attack with Foundry Street Denizen because they... Well, actually, no, we probably should attack with Foundry Street Denizen. Where is the Tremors? I know, right? So I am going to attack with Denizen. Probably double block a 2/2. And then next turn we'll run out Sparksmith. And hopefully our opponent will have gone all in on something by then. Ooh, they're going to trade a creature. Well, it's very good that we're on the control deck plan. If this is what they want to do. Oh, what's that called? Petal Festival, nailed it. Razor Boomerang. Oh, that's cool. It's just like way more expensive Viridian Longbow though, right? I guess you get more artifact triggers. All right, opponent. You got the old kicked vines for us. Kicked vines for a war marshal. We still get a token. Got him. All right, guys. So Sparksmith should be okay here. Especially because it prevents them from successfully casting a Rancor, probably. This is what I do, though, Maverick Girl. I'm always, like, trying to find the way, you know? Okay. Life Staff. This could be Life Staff's letter time. Or just Life Staff, equip Life Staff. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. My opponent has three cards in their hand. So this way they have to commit the Rancor to this. And we might be able to get them with a Sparksmith. And it's not the end of the world. Hey, thank you very much for the bits, Ben. Appreciate that, man. Kappa bits. Gotta return your pinger to your hand. Wait, does it return the creature or the equipment? I'm kind of like lost on this one. Yep, here comes Pit Skulk. Can't block it. So maybe I should have attacked with this. Maybe I should have. We're at 13. It is a pretty good blocker now. There's another War Marshal. I think it's time to Sparksmith. Unfortunately. This is going to be pretty awk. Especially if they do have a removal spell. They've been holding. Yeah. So it is Sparksmith time. I really don't like that I want to do it on their end step. Because then they get Rancor value, but I feel like I've got a crazy plan. And we'll be able to start gaining life off of Silvok Lifestaff here in short order. The Pit Skulk is a problem, but the rest of the stuff with Rancor on it isn't necessarily. God, oh, I knew it was coming. I knew it was coming. Frig. Oh, that sucked, guys. That really sucked. Okay. We're at very low life total. Yikes. We're dead to kicked vines unless I sack this goblin. So I'm going to play out the Forgotten Cave for next turn, play out Goblin Slutter, and then that's going to have to be what we do. I potentially want to sack this now. No, because I think having it block next turn is good. Whoa, setting up erratic explosion. I guess we only have 13 minutes left. Maybe it is time to scoop and go to game three. But yeah, we're dead to kicked vines. I don't know how we recover from this unless we find a removal spell for this Pit Skulk. I guess we could eventually get a goblin up to 4 power. Actually, we could do that like next turn. So not a big deal. Here comes Pit Skulk. Yep. I'm gonna take 4 here. I'll make them cast the kicked vines. Sure. Go to 4. And play another Nettle Sentinel, 1 card in hand. So the fact that they thought about it signals to me that they do have vines in hand, which is bizarre. And there's no point in scooping or killing Gabo here, sacking Gabo here, so we'll pass. Hordling Outburst. So if I play War Marshal, yeah. So I'm going to play War Marshal. It's going to be touch and go here for a second, guys. Just because I know I'm sacrificing it. Instead of Overhordling Outburst, where we don't get any value off the sack, although that might not be correct. I don't, maybe not going for the value play is wrong here. But no attacks. I think what I want to do is sack this now, gain two up to six, and then put this on. I guess that doesn't really matter either. Well, I'm going to sack this, right? Okay, pass the turn. We only have 12 minutes, so I have to play a little bit faster. I'm on a Goblins deck, man. I should be playing way faster than this. So on attacks, we're going to buff this bad boy up to 4 power to block Pit Skulk. They could have kicked Vines, and then we're dead. Okay. So pump this, sacking War Marshal. This is kind of the only way out, guys. That epic confrontation was so clutch. Pump this, sacking token. And Vines? Yeet! Okay, so no way to play around that. I think that's just game. You can't block it if it has lower power. So that's it. We're dead. No, you can't block Pit Skulk. We would have just died. Pit Skulk, you can't block Pit Skulk if it has higher power. I don't know how we could have gotten out of that. I guess, like, they were going to hit us for 8 anyway, so we would have just had to gain up to, like, 10 life last turn, which was that possible? We were at 6. We would have just had to sack both of our creatures with life staff on it, and then, like, play, and then we still would have died. 8, 9, 10, yeah, we still would have died that way as well. So, yeah, they just got off to a really fast start, killed our Sparksmith, and that was it. But I think we saw how important Sparksmith was there, and I agree that bringing Sparksmith in is a good call. And I think I'm going to take a one life staff for it, especially where we're on the play here. Yes, we would love to go first. Okay. Sure. I don't like two Hordling Outbursts in the opener, but we'll see what happens. We got a couple of Bushwhackers. I don't think this is a matchup where you're holding on to Bushwhackers, but we got a couple of Bushwhackers. Maybe this hand is the one that you do want to hold on to Bushwhackers for. Because we have Dragon Fodder. So if we play, if we go land, go, and they play like a 2-2, like a Nettle Sentinel, and then next turn we play Dragon Fodder, they put like a Rancor on the Nettle Sentinel. I think their clock is just faster than ours. So I'm going to play Bushwhacker out raw here. I think it'll just stand to get more damage in. They're going to have enough blockers that holding on to this probably won't matter. But yeah, a 1-1 on its own probably ain't getting there. You're probably right on that. Nettle Sentinel? Just Quirion Ranger. Okay. Well, I'm alright trading with that. So let's go to combat. Attack with a Wackadoodle. And blocks from our opponent. No blocks from our opponent. And we'll just cast... we'll cast War Marshal here. Because War Marshal can block Quirion Ranger. And we'll still have the same amount of bodies for a Bushwhacker turn next turn. Alright, opponent. Show me what you stomp. You stomping over there, bad boy? Hey, what did you do with the 13-card sideboard? Yeah, I know, it's weird that there's only 13 cards in the sideboard of this deck. I actually just noticed that, like, just that you mentioned that. That's crazy. It's like looking at the sideboard there in sideboarding, and I was like, whoa, man. Like, did you guys just notice that there are 13 cards in the sideboard? All right, we're going to let War Marshal go. Opponent's tapped out. I think... Oh man, the tokens. The tokens, it's so tempting to just get so wide before I bushwhacker. If we can make two bodies to every to each of their one body, I think I'm okay holding off and trying to get wider. I think they'll start alphaing before I do, and we can just like get 10 creatures on the battlefield. We also have Goblin War Strikes and Impact Tremors. Impact Tremors hasn't been too delicious this league. I'm not going to block this BTE this time. No. Because it'll take two of our bodies off the battlefield, and then they could just like, oh god, I guess I should have. That's a little awkward. But we're gonna outburst. And then if they want to get frisky, we're gonna have so many bodies on the battlefield that do we trade one creature with Pit Skulk here and then take six next turn? Put them down to 15 here, and then if they alpha strike, we're gonna lose two. We'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Times 2 is 12. 7 is 14. So we're still within 1 damage. Middle age spread engaged? Uh-oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? 1, 2, 3, 5. I think I am going to attack here. So if they can't kill us, then we might be able to kill them with Bushwhacker next turn with this attack. Sure. We're going to block three things. Two things. We're gonna get him for three, put them down to 16, and then hopefully we draw a land, kick a bushwhacker, and win. Hunger? Oh my god, why? Oh, is this hunger kicked vines? And we're just dead? Oh, yuck. Three cards in my opponent's hand. They're going to attack for 7. We're just going to take 7. Oh, and they're going to untap this BTE. That is savagery. Well, that's a good draw. So we'll play Sledder. So we're going to attack for lethal here. Forcing them to block. So we're going to attack for 14 with just these. We're going to attack for 16. And if they block, yeah, this is a pretty good attack. So I think I'm going to force them to block, and then they have to kill us next turn or we win. Let's go for it. Let's go for it, guys. Combat. Attack. See how our opponent chooses to block. Yep, untaps BTE. I guess hoping Stompy doesn't have another pump spell is probably not a great strategy, but... We could just wrath their board here, too. Which is probably actually better. Oh my god, is this Tangle? Feed the clan. Okay, whatever. Opponent's at 26. No, it's not lethal, but I think we're going to get to wrath their board. Now we're dead. Ugh, F. Now let's go 3-2. I'm gonna keep this. Two lands, bunch of goblins. I'm down with it. Turn one, island. I did burnt. Alright, so I guess mountain, denizen, go. Oh, wait. Hold on. Yep, you were. It's goblins, man. It's quick. Quick ones. You wait long enough, that may eventually happen. I'm assuming our opponent's going to cantrip or something here. Just going to leave up Spell, Stutter Sprite, and Heart Counter. Let's see if they want to trade with this Foundry Street Denison. I think I'm going to War Marshal here. And that way this will go up to 3. So if they're mono blue delver and they have mutagenic growth, then this is still going to trade with it. So I believe they have Spellstutter Sprite in hand. I can't imagine why they'd have anything else. They might flash in Spellstutter trade with Foundry Street Denizen, but if that's the case, then they can't ninja it back next turn. So we got that going for us. Wow, guys. I think that's the first time anyone's ever resolved to feed the clan against me. Consider me thoroughly fed. Here goes Delver Flip. Oh, what'd you think, Terry? Did you enjoy it? Gobbos are super quick. So now they can spell stutter 2 drops. No. We'll let him go. We'll pump up Denizen. We don't have any 3 drops in our deck. So what do we want to run out here? Let's see if they'll spell stutter a Denizen. And if they do, then we can sneak out an Instigator, or we can sneak out some one of these. Man, I like me a Silver Drake. I don't know what you're talking about. Silver Drake's a great card. So they took the counter bait. So we'll play Great Furnace, and we just gotta hope they don't have Daze, I guess. Yeah, we gotta hope they don't have Daze. Do we Bushwhack here? I don't think so. I think we use Bushwhacker to bait out counter magic and still get War Strike damage in next turn. They might have Daze, though. If they have Daze, they're down to 2 relevant cards in hand. Hey, man. That's what we do here. Oh, yeah, man. That's what I'm all about. You can't not play tight and not have a bunch of weird pet combos. Nigel, thanks for dropping in, man. So our opponent's going to trade their Sprite with our Foundry Street Denizen. We'll see if they flip their Delver. 3 cards in their hand. Flip off of a Gush. Yuck. Well, maybe they'll tap low for a ninja here. Okay, all right. I guess I can Gush and then go back up to 2 mana, though. Yuck. Yucking intensifies. So land here would be sweet, so that we can try to Bushwhacker, like Krenko's Command and Bushwhacker this turn, because that kind of progresses our War Strike plan. I wonder if they will Gush. Probably. They haven't made their land drop, so. Hello, Goblins. Oh, cool. This is definitely some jank. Okay, so our opponent's going down counter magic. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. So let's try land and like get pretty close to winning. Our land doesn't matter, I guess. I don't know if this is Krenko's Command War Strike. So 1, 2, so we can get 6, 7, 8. Put them down to 8. And then try to Bushwhacker for lethal next turn. I haven't played Grixis Delver yet, but it is a cool little deck. I have seen it. This is a tough one, gang. I think it's time to Bushwhacker. But this War Strike's getting a lot worse. So I'm going to kick Bushwhacker. Why would I do that, though? I think the only reason I would do that is because it just forces through a ton of damage. So I'm going to kick Bushwhacker here. They might, like, we can play around Daze with this for 1. And we'll Goblin War Strike pre-combat. And yeah, Daze is kind of bad, but it is what it is. So they go to 11, and we attack, hit him for 6. Potentially kill a couple Spellstutter Sprites. And then hopefully Goblin Slaughter plus Cranko's Command helps us win next turn. So opponent goes to 5, loses a couple creatures, a million cards in hand, Ninja on board. Oh, nice, man. Enjoy your holiday. Always good. Always good to be able to kick back and relax, take some time off. Here they come, the ninjas and Delver. Drawing a bunch of cards. Hitting us down to 10. What's up, Marzia? Enjoy your holiday tomorrow with my bud Joel here. Hope you guys are having an excellent evening. Yeah. Yeah, man. You know how it is. All right. Well, might as well do this. And try Krenko's commanding. They can't spell stutter this. And we can threaten lethal here. So let's play Goblin Slaughter. Spell stutter? Deprive. Okay. Not a huge deal. We're going to attack for 3, and we have tons of damage on board next turn. I don't think they can get us, unless they have, like, Echoing Decay. Or Echoing Truth. I think we got them, but it's tough to say. We have enough stuff on board that we should be able to win. So let's see. I still have a land in hand. So I can go up to 3 mana, they can commit a couple blockers. We've already killed the Spellstutter and 2 Fairy Miscreants, so I don't know that they have a lot of blockers in hand. And they have to play 2 off of their 3 mana here. So that's a little touchy. Man, I'm so mad about that Feed the Clan. Like, I can't give it up. I really thought we were going to get them. Frig. I really thought that they were going to untap and block with their BT. All right, opponent, do you have 2 blockers? Do you have blocker plus vapor snag? What's up, Al? Welcome back. How's your book? 6 cards in hand. We're at a fairly low life total. They're going to cantrip? They're going to gush. All right, our opponent has 2 mana. There's a good chance they found a creature. No, we won. Sweet. Echoing Truth is very bad news, but we do have Pyroblasts, which I feel like is pretty good in this deck, or against this deck. And Blazing Volleys? I don't think Blazing Volley is as good. There might be some consideration for Smash even over Pyroblast, but Pyroblast will get their Echoing Truths, it'll get their Ninjas, it'll get all that jazz. Fireblast is too risky against Hard Counter, Deprive. What else is risky against Hard Counter and Deprive? I guess Warstrike isn't as good here. It's a 1-drop. And sometimes it's just bad anyway. It's probably better against this deck than it is against removal decks. Oh! Yoga plus book? Imagine. The chill. The zen. I'd imagine. And you guys have seen me on complicated decks. It's not exactly, it's not exactly smooth. You know what? Smarksmithers are only out to, like, attacking around. Attacking or getting around a Spire Golem eventually. I guess Fire Blast does that as well. Blazing Volley isn't bad, but it's sorcery speed, so it's like actually kind of bad. So I guess I think about bringing the Warstrike back in, maybe over a Sparksmith, because they just don't have enough individual creatures that we care about. Although I feel like we have to get a... I think we will go down 1 Sparksmith over a Warstrike. We kind of saw that play out the way where it doesn't really matter if they have a ninja on board, we can still potentially beat them through that. So, yep. Here we go. Well, we have Sparksmith and Warstrike, so I guess we're going to get to try out what both of these cards do in this matchup. We'll go turn 1 Goblin Slaughter, turn 2 Sparksmith. This defends against Spellstutter sprites as well, which is actually kind of huge. We'll keep. And turn 1 Ponder. Cool. So let's hope they don't have Daze for the Sparksmith. Well, that's what I was thinking. Like, but you know, like, we have Impact Tremors and stuff like that. If we might just, you know, we might draw one of our 3 smashes and they might never find one of their golems. Although they are going to be selecting cards to find golems kind of on purpose, so you might be right about that. Slitter comes down, pass the turn. And next turn we'll play Sparksmith just to try to get it through. I feel like there might be a daze coming too. Goblin Slitter doesn't matter as much. Sure. Glad to see that now. So we might get Sparksmith down. I'd rather they daze here, I guess, so that they can't do ninja and something else. So yeah, let's hope they don't have daze. Because this will help a lot against future Spellstutter sprites. Sweet. Might have more Piracy Charm, but now we have Sparksmith. This is pretty bad against Vapor Snag too. So expensive compared to the rest of our deck. Do they shuffle with their first ponder? No. So I imagine a ninja's coming. They're probably going to try to hit their land drop off this ponder if they don't already have it in hand, and then ninja off of this fairy. Which isn't great. But they're going to be low on mana. So we can at least kill ninja with Sparksmith, and then probably like play Slitter, kill the ninja, and then play War Marshal. Building our way up to a quite good War Strike. Sparksmith is weird in this matchup. I think Sparksmith is weird in a lot of matchups. They're not going to shuffle. Oh, what? Come on. Jerk. So they found their other Piracy Charm. We're drawing a bunch of lands. All right, so we're going to play Slitter and War Marshal while they're not holding up counter magic. And then next turn, we're going to cycle this Forgotten Cave. Hopefully we can find something to go with our War Strike, even if it just something else gets countered instead of War Strike. But our opponent has four cards in hand, and they've manipulated the top of their library a couple of times without shuffling. So I imagine there's something... Yeah, imagine there's something that they want to be doing. That's a lot of ponders. I feel like the value goes down a little bit. It kind of becomes closer to Brainstorm at that point, where you're like ponder locked. You can always shuffle, I suppose, after you've drawn all of those real good cards off the top of your library. But here comes the pressure, so... They might try to Piracy Charm this, so I'm just going to turn off auto yields. We might want to sacrifice this. We also might just want to pay for the Echo on this. Because we have so much mana, so little action. Miscreant, okay. Well, this is looking like a little bit better of a... They're still not shuffling off their ponders, too. This is looking like a little bit better of a Blazing Volley matchup. I think I might pay Echo. Opponent only has three cards in hand. We want that value if we can get it. And then we'll draw for turn and we'll see what happens. We'll still have two mana, so we can like still cycle this War Strike, but our opponent's tapped out too. So like if we want to sneak through three mana worth of spells, next turn is the time to do it. Yeah. Yeah, I think I am though. But they don't have any hard removal. This is tough, guys. I don't think I'm going to. I know it sounds silly. I know it sounds silly, but I'm not going to. I probably should have sacked something to a goblin. We draw Dragon Fodder, which is a good justification for having not done it. So I think the play is to cycle Forgotten Cave. That way we'll be able to Dragon Fodder and Goblin War Strike before combat while our opponent's tapped low. There's Denizen, but we can't wait another turn, so we will Dragon Fodder. No, we didn't see any dazes, so yeah, hope there isn't a daze coming here. Go to combat and swing with our guys. We can protect Slitter by sacking a couple of goblin tokens, and that's cool. Alright, sweet. So our opponent goes down to 13. Ponder probably setting up this Delver. Whew. Well, at least we used all our mana, huh, gang? Opponent finds a snap. Oh, snap. It's not good. Not good at all. Even just snap on Miscreant's pretty good. Kills tokens for free. Essentially. This is aggressive. This is real aggressive. Unless the plan is to snap the Sledder. Are they gonna ninja? I guess Ninja Gush is like real bad here. Because I'll get to go back up to 2 mana for their snap. Oh, don't have a Gush. Don't, opponent. No Gush, please. No Gush, please. Give me an opportunity to win the game by drawing a Bushwhacker. It'll be so epic. Well, they're just going to hit their land drop anyway. Okay. I guess. We missed a point of damage early on in this game, guys. So make sure you don't let me live that one down too easy. Oh my god, and I was thinking so hard in that Stompy matchup. I'm really mad about that. I'm really mad about how I didn't play around Feed the Clan. I didn't even think about it. Sure. So I'm going to snap a token. That was weird. Oh. All right. Well, Hordling Outburst. We can't win here, but we're going to come close. Denizen, get that F6 value. Go to combat, attack. And we might have him next turn. Bushwhacker would have been so sweet. Right, so we can only hit for 8 here. So we're not going to try to kill them just yet. We're at 12, that's relevant. Our opponent is going to get to look for their Echoing Decay, or Echoing Truths and stuff, but Goblin Slayer plays around that pretty well. Got a good chance to win next turn. Here they... What? Sure. Opponent gonna hit us for 6, down to 6, draw a card off Ninja. I don't understand what's going on here. Miscreant, okay. That's gonna draw a card. I guess another flyer is lethal in the air next turn. Which is relevant. Maybe we should have blocked Ninja. But I think it just gives us such a good chance to win, to just leave all of our creatures back. Opponent will just pass. Okay. Forgotten Cave, we'll cycle that. See if our opponent's F6'd or not. They have not. Oh, deck, please. All right, go to combat. And they only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to leave back 1 goblin. Maybe 2 goblins to block Ninja. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We can only attack for 8 anyway. All right. Swings like this. So this way, if they have a bounce spell for this, they can't just... They'll have to have 2 bounce spells or a flash flyer here to win. See what they want to do. I'm cool with them blocking. For sure. We're dead to Spellstutter anyway. They might know that. Once we get to end step, the illusion will have lifted. Drawing 2 lands there, pretty hurting. Playing against lethal 4-on-1, so that's maybe our opponent understands what lethal means. There's no reason we'd have to commit 5 mana worth of stuff next turn. Do you just have a Spellstutter, FT-dub? No Spellstutter. Okay. Yep. They might have another Piracy Charm. That would be so fitting if they had Piracy Charm. Opponent's going to attack with everything. Okay. So we might as well chump Ninja. That might matter. Because if we don't die this turn, we die next turn. Do you have Piracy Charm? Oh my god.
Oh, leaving the goblins back won them the game. I'm so mad. Oh.
Oh, I'm so mad. I am so, so mad right now. Okay. Sure. I am so done with getting punished by cards, like the only cards I'm not playing around. Okay, apparently they're on mutagenic growth. Yeah. I could absolutely go for a hug right now. Oh my god, I'm mad. I'm so mad. I'm so mad. If this was a speed run, I would reset. This sand's pretty bad. I would take a one land six over this. It has impact tremors and a bunch of token producers, but it has one land and a three drop as well, and mostly two drops and a couple of one drops that do nothing on their own. So, we'll mulligan. This has some one drops that also do about the same thing, but we'll keep it. We're gonna bottom a two drop. Brutal. Okay. Ban Delver? No. No, man. I went 4-1 last night with a black-white deck. You're trying to tell me blue's too strong? Should I just make a supercut of all the times I beat Delver decks? Because I beat Delver with some pretty bad decks before. Like. All right, opponent bottoms one, tops the other. Ah, that's an okay draw. Not one I'm completely happy to see. But yeah, we're gonna have to draw land. Tutswit. Gonna go like this. If our opponent, they're gonna cantrip before they make their land drop, but okay, cool. Cool. Our turn. More two drops that we can't cast. I'm holding on to Bushwhacker because of what the rest of our hand looks like. This is one of those weeks where I'm like, writing the article after this is just going to be backbreaking. All right, opponent, three mana, doing nada. What's this? Nope. Not even a little bit. All right, mountain. Yes. Or on a dragon fodder. I imagine non-creature spells have more hate than creature spells. That was probably the best play our opponent could have made. Just ban insect aberrations. No, our opponent does not seem to be thoroughly on the day's plan. They do seem thoroughly on the have a bunch of counter spells and then tapping out on their own end step. I think we just gotta start forcing some action with bushwhackers. Or, you know, no, we don't. Let's try to dragon fodder again. They can't spell stutter it. I'd rather. Okay. Double spell stutter. Okay. Well, sure. So now we stand a chance at potentially getting out a bushwhacker next turn, which is nice. I will sack both of these goblin tokens to save this guy. The worst way next turn could go is our opponent makes a land drop, ninjas, and then has infinite counter spells left. I told you PG. Not that kind of action. Just wholesome action. Great. Okay, guys, this isn't looking good, but we do have three power on board to attack with. Oh, did I? Oh, man. Shh. Shh. You heard nothing. Yep. Let's go to combat. I doubt our opponent will flash in a spell stutter. Guys, what? How far into the stream are we? How far into the stream are we? I gotta write this down. Minute 31. 131, cut out the cuss. Just gonna write that down real quick. They won't catch it. They won't catch it. Nobody report me on YouTube, okay? All right, Instigator, go. I'll see your spell stutter and hope you don't have infinite counter magic to follow up. The reason I'm not leaving back blockers for Ninja is because we can't win by blocking. So, if this is another Ninja, then we're getting Delvered. I may never curse or seldomly curse, but I'm focusing on that more than gameplay all the time. Ow, you're not behaved. Certainly not. Did we have the naked news? Probably. Yes, opponent, Ninja, just do all the things. We're wholesome. Yeah, we're some wholesome people. Some pretty awful stuff happens here too, though. Mm-hmm, opponent. What you thinking about? What you thinking about over there? And that's why I'm okay hosting you, because it's a good contrast, you know? That's the after hours part of the stream. Yeah, we're dead. Opponent has spell stutter for our next spell. They're gonna draw two extra cards a turn. And we're just dead. That's right. What's up, TMJ? Tonight has been bumpy. Oh, great. 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 I think we're dead, guys. Probably should have thought about how I could win this game last turn, but forcing spell stutters is probably the way. Maybe I left a creature back. They would have just got Ninja down, so it would have been net one card down. But yeah, we're pretty close to just being dead. Pass the turn. We'll block these Ninjas. Take infinite damage. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. There's a reason that this build of Goblins has only 5-0'd twice in the last month. And not because they didn't play around Feed the Clan. I'll give it that. Ugh. I guess it's actually supposed to be like this. It's the 13-card sideboard. Should have gone down sideboard cards. I feel ya. Should have gone down sideboard cards and played around literally everything. Well, opponent, at least you can't spell stutter me again next turn, huh? Feels good, man. This is my boogeyman, too. I talked about that on the Color Commentary podcast. If you guys haven't checked that out, you definitely should go check out Color Commentary's last episode. I did an interview with him, and it was phenomenal. Just an incredible experience. And I feel like I talked about a lot of the stuff I care about in terms of Pauper. So I think you should check it out. I'm a lot more candid in the podcast. I'm not. It's like one of the only types of content I've done where I wasn't focusing on anything the whole time. So, yeah, you should check it out. There's spell stutter in hand. Okay. Okay. Nice. Opponent flips Delver off of counterspell. Come on over, opponent. We're dead so many ways. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So they had us down to 1 anyway. Let's just see if they had it. Let's see if they had it all. Let's see if they had it all. So we're going to block like this. So they're going to counter our Pyroblast, and then if they have Mutagenic Growth, we die. Or Piracy Charm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think this is kind of cool, because this is one of those like more traditional Delver builds. So they're going to counter this. And well, they can spell stutter. They also have a counter spell. Let's see if they have a pump spell just to close it up right now, too. No pump spell. Live another day. Dag nabbit. All right, guys. Mega dead here. Peace out, Delver. All right. We lost the die roll. So we're on the draw. Bad news. Not matchy lands. Bad news continuing. But we can go Foundry Shoe Denison into a Mog War Marshal, which is a pretty good start for Gabos. So I'm going to go with that. Oh, man. Yeah, no, that'd be sweet, right? Okay, we should be good against this deck. I feel like we have enough... We got enough value that we should be able to get under a control deck. So let's try doing that by leading on Foundry Shoot Denison. I think Sledders are going to be more important later on. Opponent's playing super fast. They might be on like no creatures. Yeah, just like meeting any of those guys would be incredible. Like even meeting like Lynx and Proteus and Tass, like Terry, like anybody. Ben, I just want to meet you guys. Lizardoo, like... What are you up to? I know there's a lot of Canadians, too. There's a lot of, like, Toronto-based Pauper people. Two cards on top, so opponent hitting their land drops. We're going to get a good turn here this turn, like a Fire Blast, for sure. So we'll play a Mog War Marshal, pump up the guy, get in for three. Look at this pretty pumped-up Gabo boy. And pass turn. Our opponent might play an X3 and let us... resolve a Sparksmith next turn, which would be sweet. I did mean you. I don't know any other Terrys, I guess. Maybe like Terry from the Trailer Park Boys, that guy that yells really loud. Oh, man. Yeah, no, that would be super cool. Jerry James is like so nice, too. When I was about to run Milver, they totally gave me the rundown on how to run it, like in Discord. You know, I was like, that was that week that for some reason the league results didn't get posted. And they didn't post the challenge results. And Milver did particularly well. So I was like, hey, man, they didn't post your deck list. I want to run your exact 75. Is there any chance you can give me some insight on what you ran so that I can take it out and have a good time with it? And they were like, yeah, sure, man. So we'll pump the Foundry Shoot Denison, get in for a bunch, have a bunch of creatures on board. Hope our opponent doesn't have Disfigure because I didn't pass priority there. We had to do a pre-combat anyway, actually. Maybe Sparksmith was the play, kill the X3 next turn, but I feel like they would have played an X3 there. Confirm Chernobyl. That would be really cool. For just the fun, yeah, man. Get in there. Get some JFF server fun. No shrivel one time. No echoing whatever. That's not that bad. Put on something at one blue mana. Ooh, War Strike, eh? So, I think now is the time to War Strike. And even potentially Fire Blast, but... So, we're going to War Strike you for... five, down to nine, attack for four, put them down to five. Actually, I think we can just win here. So let's go for the win, huh? Let's go. I'm not playing goblins to not be risky. They probably don't have Vapor Snag. Attack for five, and Fire Blast you. Boop, shboop. GG's. Sweet. Have a good night, Maverick Girl. Thank you very much. And you get yourself good sleep tonight. Wicked. I'll catch you in a bit as well. All right, guys. Let's play some fast games. We're going to Pyroblast probably. I don't know, man. It's really weird sideboarding with this deck. I think blue-black control is one of our best matchups. That was a sweet win. I think it was. We went Foundry Shoot Denizen... Mog War Marshal, Crank Oak's Command, Goblin Sledder. Yeah, turn four. Come on. Come on with the sleep. So I don't know. This stuff definitely isn't coming in. Life Staff isn't relevant. The Pyroblast is a consideration, but I don't know what Pyroblast is better than. All right. Sounds good. I think we're fine. I think our main deck is just fine. I don't think there's, like, we have no graveyard hate. We just gotta go fast. Pyroblast is my only consideration, and I think I would take out, like, Fireblast for it, but I think we just need a start similar to that. Hey, thanks for the salt bits, Ben. Just playing a bunch of burn in the gauntlet. Whoa. There's just a minor tremor. Sucks. Drawn like crap, man. We've had a pretty variance-laden night here tonight in matchups. You see Pyro over Warstrike? Yeah, I guess our board is going to be clear a lot of the time. This will counter Muldrifters. I don't know if they're salty. They got to expect it. They did play super fast. But yeah, I think maybe we will bring in Pyros. Oh, my name's Jeff, TMJ. J-E-F-F. Just, Jeff, you know? So many things I need to teach you, Al. Well, I'm excited to do that. No lands, so we have to mulligan. This hand's pretty bad, too. This hand's, like, really bad. But I don't think going to 5, even on the draw against this deck, is a good idea. Definitely don't want that. Watch our opponent go, like, turn 2 Wrench Mind. Salt, salt, salt. They can't do that now. Just so many decks in the gauntlets that I had zero interest in piling again, except Elves, Boros, Burn, and maybe Hexproof. I haven't gotten to play Hexproof for the series yet. I'm really looking forward to that. Oh, you can't go Infinite at all? That sucks. Man, I had some glory days back in Eldritch Moon Limited where I was just, like, Infinite for a few weeks. I was, like, drafting, like, 2 to 3 times a night. It was so sweet. That was back when Limited Resources broke the white-green delirium tech. Pauper Tim, you're one of the Pauper founders? Really? Congrats, man. This format's rad. You just lurk, eh? How you been? Thanks for dropping in. I hope you're enjoying the stream. I hope you're enjoying me playing your, I assume, favorite format. Pauper Tim, you should PM me because I'm always looking for resources to look at, like, historical decks. I would love, if you are truly one of the founders, I would love to talk to you about the foundations of Pauper and just everything that has come of it. I think that would be so cool to talk about. So I think our opponent's on, like, Prohibit here, so I'm going to try to run out Sparksmith, and then we'll start playing tokens next turn. Okay, cool. So I'm not going to Prohibit Sparksmith. Next turn's going to be interesting. I don't... Ooh, our opponent's just, like, super dead here. If this is going to be how this goes. So we'll play land, go to combat, attack with Sparksmith. Especially if they don't have counter magic, we get down this Hordling Outburst, and then next turn if we draw land, we could, like, double tokens. But we do want to get this Warstrike out of our hand pretty soon. They can't... I don't know what counterspell. Hydro Blast, I guess? Sure. That kind of sucks. But it is what it is. Our opponent's missing land drops. Let's go. More token generators. So let's go to combat. We'll attack, and then we'll make some more tokens. Opponent at 21 off this Radiant Fountain. Relevant. Yep. Got another Hydro Blast. I can't imagine you'd... Wow. Okay. Yeah, you definitely are. Like, thank you for an amazing format. Sweet. Well, I'm super glad you decided to make Pauper one of the places that you enjoy. I think this turn we're just going to cast Founder Street and then cast some tokens. We'll see if they want to Hydro Blast any of this stuff. And then next turn we'll try to force counter magic before we Warstrike. But we're in pretty good shape. That's all good. That's all good. You just drift off into sleep. A good night's sleep is important. And did I win? Did I win? I think I do believe that. Or I think I do remember that. That's really cool, Pauper Tim. I would absolutely love discussing early Pauper with you. I think that would be incredible. A really amazing experience. All right, opponent. Additional war strikes. So we're going to try to bait out that hard counter. What do you got, opponent? You got hard counter? This is not bad in and of itself. Okay, they're going to let it go. So now we're going to go to combat. We'll go to combat after this. We'll see if they tap any mana to remove one of our creatures. Or any of our creatures. And then we're going to try to war strike. Oh, sweet. Okay. So we're going to attack for a bunch. No Hydro Blast. Do we have lethal? No. So we'll try to war strike you. Hydro Blast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Down to 6. Oh, guys, we're so close. I didn't want to go for that. I felt like they had counter magic, so I wanted to try to play into that about as well as I could. What's up, Darth Juggalo Sam? That's awesome, Pauper Tim. So what was, like, how did the meta start? Like, where were you in the heyday of the meta? That's a little tough. That's a little brutal. But I think we still got them so long as they don't have Hydro Blast. So Instigator. We'll force it now. Yeah, what's up, Darth Juggalo Sam? And go to combat, attack with Sparksmith. I think you eventually just get there. You eventually just end up liking all the colors. Opponent goes to 5. Let's try to war strike for 3. Fire Blast? Come on. It's now or never. No Hydro Blast. Come on. You got it? Oh! Dispel. All right. Maybe I could have read that, but I feel like putting him up against it is a pretty good strategy here. Pristine Talisman, that doesn't matter. So we'll have to have another removal spell. Combat, go to attacks. Do you have a disfigure opponent, or are you just dead? Oh, this is way too close. I hate this. I hate this so much. They have 3 cards in hand. They could definitely pull out of this. Preordains, looking for more removal. Tapped out a double blue, which is relevant. We're on turn 8 and they only have 4 lands on the battlefield. Like, I feel like we should have been able to win somehow. Maybe I should have Fire Blasted earlier. Not sure. What's up, Ben? Looking to do a Pauper League. Ooh, well, what do you have access to? Evoke it, looking for a Disfigure to see if they can win. Or see if they can stop us. Not necessarily every non-mountain. We won. I think I'm going to keep it, guys. I think I'm going to keep it. I think we can have some fun with this one. Let's keep. I'm going to play Bushwhacker because we're going to play Tremors on turn 2. I think Elves is, like, quite complicated, especially in the worst matchups. Opponent, just passing the turn, no land drop. Okay. Great Furnace. Got it. So, let's Bushwhacker. Didn't have many 2/2s. Yeah, like the red deck wins version. I could see that. So I would suggest like Boros Monarch. I think that's just a very powerful, like somewhat straightforward deck. Boggles and Burn are both good. Burn gets a little bit more difficult because of timing against Prismatic Strands and things like that, but it's not too bad. It's not too complicated. So get him down to 19, and now we're going to get some fodder value. Yeah, I would say, I don't know. I think Boros Monarch is your best bet. I think it's probably the easiest one. Next to, like, Burn. Like, Burn, Boros Monarch. Burn, like, Burn has more play to it than people give it credit for, too. I wouldn't go with Gush or Brainstorm decks just yet, or Gush or Daze decks, that is, just yet. But, yeah, I agree. Thraby Baby, gonna block our whole deck. Not great news. Affinity was the top dog after the meta settled. So did that Affinity have all of the, like, it would have had Atog. Did it have artifact lands? When did you say it started? Because I think he talked about that. Yeah, Mirrodin. So it would have had all this stuff. Yeah, I go with Boros Monarch. It's, like, grindy. Like, you have to play fast, so I guess you have to be familiar with the mechanics of Magic Online a little bit more than other decks. Like, our opponent's probably not playing fast enough. Like, if we were a Tron deck, then they might be in trouble. Alright, so we'll play out Sledder, and then we're going to play out Dragon Fodder. No, I wouldn't. No, don't do Reanimator. No Atog at first. Oh, I think I saw that, and they had, like, oh, man, Binary Eye linked some information about that. There was, like, just a ton of, they had, like, Choking Tethers, and, like, they still had the Affinity creatures. I think they played that Flyer and stuff. Oh, it's so cool. It's so cool to learn about that stuff. So a removal spell on Bushwhacker is pretty brutal. Our opponent's going to get, like, a 1.5 for 1, but it is what it is. We'll see what happens. Not a thing. So they lose their blocker and core Skyfisher value, which is relevant. Gains a little life. The life gain is useful for them. Cranial Plating. Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Didn't think about the plating. okay. Drawing into more action here would be great. Deck, there's so few lands. All right, so we're just gonna Somber Hoverguard. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, the flying gets cheaper one. You know the drill. You know that guy. Play with Sledder, Impact Tremors, triggers and attack. Man, that would be really cool. That would be super duper cool. The history is really intriguing to me. I think I went to gameplay because I just didn't know very much about the format. Like, this is the thing, I think, you know, just getting in there, getting your hands dirty. Good way to do it. Our opponent not playing anything last turn is interesting. It could just be flooding out. I don't know. Tough to say. That would be sweet, though. Let's not rush anything. Let's not rush anything here. I had that idea for another new content series that kind of fell by the wayside. And it's huge over there, right? Like, well, I guess not really. I'm so bad at geography. I probably shouldn't even begin to say that I know anything about geography. But I know it's really big in Italy, and it's really big in Brazil as well. I know that's two of the places where Pauper is kind of huge. It seems like they have a fair amount of self-sanctioned tournaments in Haruruya as well, which is cool. Opponent is going to screech the birds. I hope they don't just have a million of those. I think this deck is better against Battle Screech than others, though. No land. Sweet. All right, so play Dragon Fodder. Deal 2 damage, attack with our Gabos. We're pretty close to getting lethal. Let's begin Argentina, too. That's really cool. Yeah, and I think it's funny because we're still suffering from... we're still suffering from... Banned and restricted lists. Kind of making Pauper a weird format, right? Part of me is okay with trading off of the birds here because it's less likely that they're going to... Okay, well, yeah. Now I'm going to have to... sack one of these guys. I do want to keep one of my Sledders around, but I also want to kill these birds because it's less likely that they're able to flashback Battle Screech next turn. And them getting just a free Battle Screech is relevant. Don't know what holding on to a land means, but you know, I check for small Japanese tournaments. Doesn't everyone? They're like small and in Japan. No, it's just, it's on the Haruryo website. They have local tournaments and they post the results there, which is pretty cool. And sometimes you can find them on MTG Top 8 as well. If anybody else has any, like Pauper Tim, if you have any other Pauper deck list resources, like that's huge. Like if you know any from the past that are still kicking around, like I'd be super into hearing about them. So let's see if our opponent can play a bunch of white creatures and save themselves. I don't understand how they can have four cards in hand and still, like, not do anything. Maybe they have, like, Palace Sentinels, a bunch of Prismatic Strands. We saw just how well that went last game. Yeah, man. You can get your small Japanese tournaments. I basically am restricted to just Googling, right? The community and the people put tons and time of effort hosting events, even when the original people left, is what made it keep going. So, and maybe this is like a kind of a misnomer. Opponent's going to lightning bolt this. I feel like that doesn't... They might have an electricery. So... Let's keep one boy around. But I'm not going to play that far around electricery main deck. I guess I could cast it in response. Oh man, TMJ, no way. I would love to see that. So Pauper Tim, was it standard Pauper in the beginning, or was that the most popular format? Because I know that kind of ebbed and flowed for a little while, that standard Pauper was more of a thing sometimes. Or was that just Wizards kind of doing their thing, kind of like what they're doing with Arena right now? Like, are we seeing the birth of a new Pauper format? I guess you're one of the only people I've ever talked to that's seen one. That's super cool. Sorry for gushing over a person in my chat, guys. No electricity. More screeching. Get screeched in here. Palace Sentinels? Cast a Palace Sentinels. Tight. Heckin' tight. Warstrike would be pretty nuts here. Warstrike, off top. Oh, that's good too. Hello, Toxic Citizen. Welcome to the Janku Banku. Glad to have you. I hope your toxicity levels decrease to the point where they're at the very least not lethal. Never like hearing about somebody having a hard time with their toxicity levels. We get the Monarch a jillion times. We're also going to win right now. Is it League of Magic? I do check League of Magic, but I find, like, I can't speak, like, the language, so I find it very difficult to, I find it very difficult to navigate and, like, find new decks all the time, I guess. Fire Blast our opponent for the win! You should be. Absolutely 100% jealous of the Tim Gush. People didn't start doing standard Pauper and modern Pauper till later. Okay. What do you mean by souped up? Oh, powerful? Oh, rip. Man, that's funny. Same. All right, Boros Monarch. So we want our smash to smithereens, and probably they might be on the tokens plan, so Blazing Volley might be relevant, but I think smash is probably better. We're going to take it out for stuff that isn't as good at this matchup. So we'll take out a couple of Sparksmiths. I guess I can kill some things, but a little risky. So we'll take out a couple of Sparksmiths, and I think we will take out... What do we want for this last smash? Yeah, we had a sweet beach here for a while, and then Chemical Factory. I think I'm going to take out one denizen, just one, because it can only attack through, like, it's like a one mana 1/1 most of the time, because they have a lot of creatures. Oh, Flaring Pain. We didn't see any, I guess you're right, though. Let's get in some Flaring Pains. I'll take out another denizen, and I'll take out a Warstrike. Nah, maybe Krenko's Command. Smell like that. We made it. So I can translate it usually, but it's usually not like perfect, I guess. It's just kind of tough to navigate. Shouts out to whoever got those last minute flaring pain suggestions in. Heck yeah. Man, that must have been crazy. Some of the first like decks, didn't they have like just huge butt creatures because it would shut the game down? I guess like a lot of early Thanks, Terry. I guess a lot of early Magic kind of revolved around stuff like that. Run 61 cards for the extra tilt on top of the mismatched lands. How about we really next level everybody and we 5-0 with a 13 card sideboard? Man, did you guys know that this deck, like when I put the deck tech up, it had a 13 card sideboard? Oh, Ben. That would be really cool. That would be really, really cool. Because like I can't really, all I can do is like I can translate the page to English with like Google Translate, which is, as everybody knows, ultra effective on card names and stuff like that, which just makes it like inefficient. It doesn't make it impossible to use or anything, but yeah, so I basically have to navigate on League of Magic by using their like deck search tool, and I couldn't figure out how to narrow it down to just Pauper decks. All right, gang. All right, guys. Let's clinch the 2-3 here. Why did I do that? Well, Impact Tremors helped a lot. So we have Impact Tremors, a bunch of token production, and a War Strike. So, sure. Sucks to your 3 of an Inspector opponent. Good. We did want third Mountain. And Birds. 3, baby. Got it. I think we do have Singleton Mountains. That's kind of really funny. Oh, man. Double Hordling Outburst on Impact Tremors. Hoo do you get a couple Goblin War Strikes in there? Man, this is going to be nuts. We got the, for the last game, I think we got the win with the Goblin War Strikes. Man, thank you so much. It's crazy being in that echelon of content creators because, like, oh, don't blow this up, please. Okay. It's awesome being in that echelon because Magic the Gathering strat, like I picked them up a few years ago. Like they were some of the first Pauper content creators, period, that I was watching. They're great. Seriously. Alright, guys, let's cast a bunch of Hordling Outbursts and then fade Electricery to make Goblin War Strike insane. How do you guys feel about that? Outburst. Tremors. Pass the turn. I don't really even want to attack him with the Raven Inspector, but maybe we have to. This could be, it's weird. Like when you're playing against Boros Monarch, usually it's like the race to whoever can wipe the 1/1s. But in this matchup, I don't know. I don't really like Blazing Volley. I don't think Methodical's been as active lately. I mean, they might have just posted a new challenge though, so don't quote me on that. I don't really want a War Strike into 2 open mana either. Mm-hmm. Yeah, his brews are sweet. I believe he was one of the minds behind Rallygond. I believe that's to their credit. I think they were one of the Rallygond brewers. Opponent playing glacially slow here. I am stoked about the Pauper Gauntlet. I think that's really cool. All right, Battle Screech, flashback Battle Screech, I assume. If that's the case, it might be time to just like War Marshal. I think that might be what I do next turn. Instead of running Outburst, I think we'll just War Marshal War Strike, unless we draw land, of course. Untapped land is like totally fine here. Sweet, yeah. I wish we got to chat more. That's one of the players I haven't chatted with a whole bunch. Okay. So in the interest of playing around Electricery, I'm going to do this turn. I know that it's not ideal, but I'm going to do this turn. And then I'm going to play out Forgotten Cave so that I can Hordling Outburst War Strike next turn. And I think we only get in one extra damage by trying to attack through birds this turn if we do it that way. So we'll War Strike you for 5, play a Forgotten Cave, and pass the turn. Hopefully we can win next turn. Fizz du Braco? Did I say that right? That's awesome, Pauper Tim. Well, any insights you have on the format are wholly accepted. All right, our opponent main phases Electricery. We're going to get back our Gabo. So next turn should still be okay. 3 mana, 1 mana, no mana, some mana, Alchemist Vial. All right. We're going to get him. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can hit for 7 next turn. We can War Strike for 7 next turn. War Strike plus Impact Tremors. And then we have Instigator to maybe finish it off. Thraby baby. We do have to be wary of our opponent's clock here, especially where they can draw cards. Like, they're soon... Oh, wow. No attacks. Okay. Continue... Or begin to being less wary of our opponent's clock. Oh, the jank is my favorite. Jank out of 10 every time. All right, so 1, 2, 3, Hordling Outburst. And there's no point holding this, I don't think. Like, our opponent has shown us that they're quite comfortable on the Electricery plan, and we should be able to win just by resolving creatures next turn, so long as they don't have some life gain or a Prismatic Strands. So let's just hope they don't find it. They're at 3, we're at 20, we have an Impact Tremors on board. Like, just please, please give this to me. We've lost harder in this matchup. Oblivion Ring, oh no! Our opponent found the tech. They found it. Is this another Electricery? Oof. Oh no, drawing a card. Okay. Okay. We still Fire Blast. Smash! Oh my god! Epic. Alright, so we will smash to smithereens your Prophetic Prism? GG? GG 2-3? Imagine I would have done it to the vial. We did it.